How confident are you that the group can deliver the votes for the vice president, considering that four of the other five governors in the Bangsamoro have thrown their support for Mr. Bongbong Marcos?
Well, on the other hand, yes, we admit that four governors have endorsed Bongbong Marcos, and then aside po namin, we have also, aside from the constituent of the governors and constituent of the government, the BARM, we also have our own constituent, that is the Moro Islamic Liberation Front. The Moro Islamic Liberation Front is very much intact in all over the region. And we are, kasi hindi pa po kwan, hindi pa po disbanded ang MILF. Hanggang hindi natapos ang implementation. Ganon din po, even the Bangsamoro Islamic Armed Forces ay hindi pa po fully disbanded because hindi pa kami naka-decommission in full. So, we count on our own constituent na may deliver namin na ang majority vote for Lenny Robredo in the region.
All right, Chief Minister Ibrahim, is your endorsement of Lenny Robredo an automatic endorsement of the vice presidential bid of Senator Kiko Pangilinan? And if not Pangilinan, who is the Bangsamoro's choice for VP?
Actually, our endorsement is very specific only to VP Lenny Robredo. So yung mga ibang pan is we are still on the process of finalizing whom we will endorse for vice president and for senators.
And do you have a short list perhaps you can share with us on who you will endorse for VP and senator?
For VP, we have invited because in consonance with our commitment to the current President Rodrigo Roa Duterte, we will support his daughter Sara Duterte. So we are inviting vice presidential candidate Sara Duterte, Mayor Sara, to visit us and present to us her program. And we will see if it compatible with our own program, then we might be endorsing here. Pero what of now, wala pa hong response sa side niya.
Yes, the BARM is supposed to be poised to deliver about 2.5 million votes to whoever the group, of course, is endorsing. But the other four governors are endorsing Mr. Bongbong Marcos. Are you confident that you could deliver at least a substantial part of those votes?
Yes po. Unang-una nga, mayroon kaming sariling constituent na hindi po sakop ng mga governors. And then, yung mga governors din, hindi naman ho kan. Fully, sa halimbawa sa Tawi-Tawi, mayroon din grupo doon na nag-endorse kay VP Lenny. Then sa Lanao ay ganun din, divided din po ang votes sa Lanao.
Yes.
Then sa Maguindanao is ganun din. Very close ang kan sa five ng governors na sa Maguindanao, yung isang governor po is supporting Bongbong Marcos,
right.
And then yung isang governor is with Lenny.
Right.
So very close po ang fight sa kwan. So we see na we have the edge as far as delivering of votes for the BARM.
And we can't just be talking about BARM because those choices, now that you're deliberate and intentional on endorsing Robredo, it may also influence Muslim communities outside the BARM. Now, how big an influence or how confident are you that this will rub off in the other communities, Muslim communities in particular, outside the Bangsamoro Autonomous Region in Muslim Mindanao?
You know, part of the agreement is the Barm government can still extend support to the Bangsamoro outside the territory, outside the area. So ginawa namin ito during the past 3 years na administration namin, we have been in good relation with the Bangsamoro outside the territory sa panig ng mga ayuda namin during the COVID. We have reached until Luzon and Visayas nasa pag-deliver ng aming mga ayuda sa mga Bangsamoro na nasa area na ito. So we are also confident that whatever support whoever we support in the presidential election, they will also support it.
And one one of the big issues here is Marawi rehabilitation, perhaps a persistent issue in Mindanao this elections. Are you happy with how it has been handled, and what are your expectations from the next president as regards Marawi rehab?
Well, actually, ito nga yung naging malaking problema, because hanggang ngayon, the Marawi rehabilitation ay hindi pa rin po substantially addressed. Mm. Kaya ito rin po ang isa sa pinangako ni President Vice President Lenny Robledo na she will work out na matuloy itong rehabilitation ng Marawi. Kasi hanggang ngayon ay hindi pa natin masasabi na kahit na 30% ay hindi pa rin we have already assisted the task force created by the President na magsagawa ng rehabilitation of Marawi, pero it is not yet enough. We need to focus more on Marawi in order to fully rehabilitate.
Yes, and Chief Minister Ibrahim, perhaps as a parting shot. Now, the struggle for lasting peace and progress in Muslim Mindanao has remained a continuing aspiration despite significant gains in recent years. Now, do you see the fruition of what is ideal in the next 6 years? And how different do you think will the outcome be if Bongbong Marcos wins the elections?
Now, we are way unang-una po. I think we have several attempts in addressing the problem in PAN. Marami na pong nangyaring negotiation, and then pagpatayo ng gobyerno, merong ilang beses pong napalitan itong gobyerno, regional government. Pero kaiba po itong regional government ngayon, because very distinct po kasi ito po ay ministerial and parliamentary in form. The first time na magkaroon ng isang gobyerno na ganito dito sa BAM. And then on our side also, we still enjoy the support of the international community. Sa ngayon po ay tumutulong sila European countries, at saka iba-ibang mga countries, Middle East countries, and even African countries are coming in, tumutulong po sila para because they see that this is the last chance for the region to really recover, and we are hoping that talagang kung magiging patuloy at magpatuloy ang cooperation namin, just like what we have done with the past current administration, ay sa susunod na administration, Pangulo, ay natitinitiyak po namin na magkakaroon ng tunay na peace and order, long-lasting peace and order at progress dito sa region. In fact, even in the form of investment, malaki po ang itinaas ng investment dito ngayon after the setting up of the BARM. And then poverty also incidence was reduced significantly. The first time itong last year na nagkaroon ng double digit na reduction of poverty sa region after this. So we are very confident na sa pagtutulungan namin ng administration. Now, what we also look into President presidential candidate Bongbong Marcos. Pero nakita namin na niminsan po wala siya pong nababanggit tungkol sa programa or whatever plan he has on the BARM. And unfortunately, hindi po siya one. Despite we also extended our invitation to every candidate, ay hindi po siya dumalaw sa amin. So we comparatively with the Laney administration ay nakita namin na malayo po ang pagkakaiba.
All right, let's leave it at that. Mr. Alhaj Murad Ibrahim, BARM Chief Minister, thanks a lot for joining us this morning.
Thank you very much for for giving us this opportunity for us to bring out our views. Thank you for
all right, sir.
Assalamu alaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
All right, sir. Thank you.